Hello everyone, welcome to Blue Cube channel. Many people have asked me why the color of the character's bones should be changed in animation and what is the use of this feature in Anime Studio. I recorded this video to answer this question to show you that coloring character bones is very important and practical in animation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you subscribe so that you can see the next tutorials. I have a character in the middle of the scene and the time indicator is on the first frame. Now I want to move the character's hands using the Manipulate Bones tool. I move the character's hand back a little. After moving the character's hand, two keyframes are immediately created in the first frame. Also on the left side are bone angle and selected bone angle. And selected bone angle is red because it shows the currently selected bone and its related keyframes. I also move the other hand of the character. Now, if you look at the timeline, even though I created a new move, no new keyframe has been added to the timeline. Even if I select or move the head bone, no keyframes are added to the timeline, and all the bone movement seems to be saved to these two keyframes. Now I put the slider on the 12th frame and move the character's hands. I also animate the character's head. In this way, only two more keyframes are added to the timeline. Note that a keyframe has been removed from the timeline, and the reason is that we did not create a keyframe for the head turned bone in the first frame. Because as I said, the red bone only shows the currently selected bone and currently we cannot see the keyframes of all the bones separately. Now let's create different colors for the bones of the head and hands to show the use of coloring the bones. I choose all three bones of this hand and choose a yellow color for them. In order not to cause any problems, it is better to put the time indicator in the zero frame. I select all three bones of the other hand of the character and choose pink color for them. For the head turn bone, I choose yellow. I choose a green color for the head turned bone so that the color of the bones is different. Now I place the slider on the first frame and move the character's hand. You can see that a yellow bone and line along with a keyframe have been added to the timeline. In this way, we can see the keyframes of the yellow bones of the character's hand in the timeline. I also move the other hand of the character. Because we made the bones of this hand pink, a bone and a pink line along with a keyframe appear in the timeline. I also click on the head turn bone, as a result, a bone and a green line will be added to the timeline. Now I place the slider on the 12th frame and move the character's hands and head with the Manipulate tool. As a result, you can see in the timeline that in frame 12, a keyframe has been created for each bone we painted. Also, the red bone is the bone we have selected now. Therefore, the important use of coloring the bones is that, for example, if I want to remove or modify the keyframes of the head turned bone that we marked with green color, I can easily find its keyframes in the timeline. Now, holding the left click, I select its keyframes and press the delete key. As a result, only the movements related to the character's head are removed and the rest of the character's movements remain. I turn the character's head to the right again. So I will remove the keyframes related to yellow bones. We can see that only the movements of the yellow bones were removed. I also remove the keyframes of other hand of this character. In this way, only the movement of the head remains. Now I delete all the keyframes and hit the auto freeze keys button. In frame 1, I click on the screen with the manipulate tool. In the timeline and in the autofreeze keys mode, we can see colored bones. With the difference that bones and keyframes are created separately for angle, bone translation, and scale. I put the slider in frame 12 and set the movement for the hands and head of the character. As a result, a keyframe is created for each bone, and the colored bones are completely recognizable in the timeline. Again, we can easily remove or modify the movements of colored bones and keyframes. Also, we can change the color of the keyframes in Anime Studio. For example, I delete all keyframes and create some new keyframes. Now I want to change the color of these two keyframes so that I can easily find and modify them later. So, I select both keyframes and right-click on one of the keyframes, and then select the desired color from the label menu. In this way, the color of the keyframes also changes. Now I want to tell you some important points. Click on the main bone layer of the character and activate this button, then open the layer. I also activate this button for the t-shirt layer. Now I put the slider in the sixth frame and bend the character back a little. In this way, the name of the main bone is created in the timeline, which indicates that these keyframes are related to this character. This point is important when you have several characters in the scene and you can easily find the keyframes of each character. Now I select the t-shirt layer and move the location of one of the points with the transform tool. In this way, the t-shirt label and its related keyframes are created in the timeline. Now we can easily recognize the keyframes related to the t-shirt in the timeline. I also double-click on the t-shirt layer and change the layer's color to pink. I press the OK button. In this way, a pink color is created under the keyframes related to the t-shirt layer in the timeline, which distinguishes this layer from the rest of the layers. All these topics are very useful in making animations and managing the timeline. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.